Hello everyone, this is Jeb Hamburger from GoldStockTrades.com. Today is Friday, December 23rd, 2011. It's about 3:15 p.m. right now, and I wanted to give an update, a weekend update, to my premium subscribers. The chart that I want to look at most closely right now is the long-term treasury ETF, the TLT, which is the iShares Barclays 20-plus-year treasury bond fund. This is a long-term treasury fund that, as we saw as QE2 was expiring, we had a major run into the treasury market, and we had the reemergence of the deflationary fears that we saw in 2008, and investors were looking for liquid assets, and where they would be protected from any losing their principal. So we've seen a mass herd-like move into the long-term treasury market, so much so that investors are even willing to take negative returns and invest in a country that is dealing with major debt issues and a major increase in money supply and the potential for further credit downgrades. So we have considered and said all along that we believe that this move into the treasuries and into the dollar is a real fake out, and that investors need to be careful of this, because whenever you see a rise like this in a long-term treasury bond market, which is not supposed to be volatile like this, you have to caution is urged, and especially when we're significantly above the 200-day moving average, and we've just come off record overbought readings. Notice here, we have been saying for many weeks that we think that the debt bubble is going to collapse. And if we look at the chart right now, we had these overbought conditions in August and September. And now we've tested it. But if you've noticed here, we see that the momentum is significantly declining, even though the price is trying to break into new highs. So this is a negative divergence. And we need to be careful of a possible correction. Notice here, the overbought territory, we're slowly decreasing with the momentum. So this may become a double top here. And we may break through the 10-week moving average and either test the 200-day or even continue below like we saw in 2010 and in 2009, after the record stimulus and accommodative moves to help push up the inflation and prevent the hoarding of cash and treasuries. So let's now move on to the Dow Jones Industrial Average, represented by the ETF, the DIA, which represents the Dow Jones Industrial Average. Right now, after our October 4th reversal, we have now cleared the 200-day moving average. Remember when it first went to the 200-day average, I warned that we may see a correction to the 50-day. We bounced off the 50-day, found support, and have now broken through the 200-day. Also, we have seen the 50-day or the 10-week moving average cross the 200-day or the 40-week moving average to the upside. So we have witnessed, even through all this panic, we have said that we may see a holiday rally. And we have seen this reversal, and quite a powerful reversal, where we went from oversold conditions to overbought conditions. Right now, we are maybe testing the all-time highs. And a lot of investors may have been shaken out here in this August and September move, moving into the treasuries and dollars, when we may be setting up for a possible very strong bull market move in 2012, which may affect our sectors that we follow, the rare earths, the uraniums, and the miners, which we believe will outperform and be very strong in 2012. So stay tuned. Have a wonderful weekend and a happy holiday season.